Okay, dear students, we are going to discuss the Java database connectivity. So for this we have a client and server architecture here, in which we are going to connect our server with the client. So for the client purpose we have installed some browsers. Here we will run our Java program that will be interacting with the HTML codes. So for browsers we are having the HTML. So as browsers only understand the HTML language, we are going to connect with the help of this HTML and Java compatibility with the servers. So on the server we may have some PHP, JSP or maybe Python or any other language that is running on the server. So how we will connect with this browser client to the server with the help of that is also having the database stored in the servers. So for this we are going to install a driver. As we know, for interacting with any application we must have a driver. So we have a JDBC connector here that will interact with the databases. So the JDBC is specifically for Java and we may have the open database connectivity as well. Let's say we have a specific Java program. That is going to connect with the server. With the help of this driver, so on servers we may have the database that may have the username and passwords. In Java program for connecting we will have a class root for name that will contain the address of the driver that we have already installed on the client side. For this purpose, in the education purpose, we may have this server on the client with the help of XAMPP server. So we will firstly install the XAMPP server and this will provide a complete architecture to the client side, and we need not to purchase the server for the we need not to pay anything for the purchasing the server. So XAMPP will provide the automatic environment for us to give the Glassfish or maybe Tomcat server, and this will also will give us a MySQL panel with the help of PHP, MyAdmin. So this PHP MyAdmin will react as the database that is on the client side server in this case. So using this class of for name, we will communicate with this PHP MyAdmin and creating the prepared statement in Java, we can run the SQL, we can communicate with the database. As we know, database only understand the SQL languages, as browsers only understand the HTML. So we will supply the SQL to the database. So using the prepared statement, we will supply the SQL to the databases and SQL will reply back to these prepared statements, and these statements will be captured in a result set that can be captured as a RS statement, RS.next, RS.previous can be applied methods from these, and using these result statements which is maybe RS. So RS.next or previous can be applied in the SQL statements and we can store the data that is given by the databases, and we can store these results in our application and we can use these as per our requirement. So this is a general idea of how our client is communicating with the servers that is having the databases. So these databases can be used in an application where we can have the username, password and some other client, and some user can log into there and can get their data back to their application. So this is a complete architecture. Thank you.